How do we work? So we start with a theoretical universe with all different markets. You will notice that we avoid some markets such as high yield or leverage loans, and I will tell you why in a few minutes. We manage with many main principles: very active portfolio management, a total return approach, no predefined countries or sectors or weightings of these different markets, because we have always been benchmark agnostic. Obviously, when we manage portfolio funds or mandates, we compete against a benchmark, because sometimes it's also mandatory. But we don't really follow the benchmark, and we don't take bets against any benchmark. We buy the bonds that we like. We avoid bonds that we don't like, whatever their weight in any benchmark. I think that's the only way to deliver alpha with active portfolio management, especially in this universe where ETF and passive investments are available. And it was not the case 20, 30 years ago. So active portfolio management and alpha are very important today. That's why also sometimes portfolio turnover is kept low, because you know that transaction costs in the fixed income markets are sometimes high. And we only focus on very high quality countries and sectors. After portfolio management is more simple. We invest in both in primary market and secondary market. Currently, more in primary market because after the coronavirus crisis, after the start of the coronavirus crisis, we experienced a very active primary market, and rating agencies are very active. So we can say some opportunities, and we also have a look at relative value, and I will explain in detail this point, because when you invest in a bond, once you have selected an issuer, sometimes it's useful to see the difference between to analyze the difference between bonds denominated in dollars, in euro, or sterling or other currencies, in order to pick the best bond depending on the currency. So at the end, we focus on four main pillars: US treasuries, investment grade bonds, emerging market bonds, and some euro crossover bonds and hybrid bonds. We are mainly invested in investment grade, but we also like investment grade emerging markets. We start with a top-down analysis, almost like everybody, with economy, level of duration, positioning on the yield curve. Obviously, we focus on growth, inflation, unemployment rates, debt to GDP ratios, for example. But we also have a look at social environment and political stability, especially in emerging markets. Once we have done the top-down analysis, we have to invest in a credit portfolio, and then we develop a traditional credit analysis. We have an in-house model to analyze the credits. We also obviously have a look at broker research, and more importantly, analysis given by rating agencies. Once we have selected an issuer, we analyze if the value is better in the senior debt or in the subordinated debt. And as I just mentioned before, sometimes it is better to invest in other currencies rather than in dollars, and to hedge into dollars. We have a tool which analyzes in real time the spread between different currencies in order to pick the best spread. We have a look at liquidity, obviously, because fixed income market, as you know, is a OTC market. So liquidity is very important. Timing is important, and technical analysis is also a key tool, especially in the current market. Because we are bond managers, we manage bonds, we manage fixed income. And the problem of bonds today is that correlation with equity markets can increase dramatically. And once you have bonds in your portfolio in a global allocation, the bonds that behave exactly like equities, it's a problem, because bonds should be a hedge of equities. And when equities, when there is a correction in equity markets, you should normally make a profit on bonds and perform very well. And the summary of these markets is very important, because you have the different universes: government bonds, inflation-linked government bonds, investment grade, hybrid, crossovers, high quality emerging markets, global emerging markets, high yield and leverage loans, and private debt. And you see that for us, there is really a limit between global emerging markets and high yield, because when you see the correlation with equity markets below global emerging markets, you have really a very high correlation, and you have a very high default risk. So in our universe, we focus on high quality, high liquidity, and low correlation with equity markets. We like high quality emerging markets. We are not in favor of global emerging markets with very low quality countries, but high quality emerging markets are very attractive. Probably today it's a bit too early to invest in high quality emerging markets, but in the coming weeks, in the coming months, I think that this will be the future. Because investment-grade corporates in euro and dollar are driven by central bank purchases. So the spreads will decrease dramatically. But even today, the rally was so impressive that probably there is no value left in some investment-grade bonds in dollars and euro. But good quality emerging market corporates are not bought by their central bank. So we will probably switch in the coming weeks our credits in euro and dollar, European and US credits, into very high emerging market corporate bonds denominated in dollars. That's probably the future of a global investment-grade portfolio today. Inflation-linked government debt on one side, and high-quality corporates from emerging markets on the other side. We are bond managers, and high-yield and leverage loans have a too high correlation with equity markets, and they behave like equities. At the end of the day, they behave like equities. So once you have done your homework, once you like a bond, and if the bond is rated high yield, junk, maybe it's better to buy directly the equity. we prefer to focus on very high liquidity, low volatility, and very low correlation with equity markets. Hybrid corporate debt is very attractive today because liquidity is a little bit low, but default risk is the same as investment grade because it's subordinated debt of very high quality companies. That's why we focus on hybrid debt. We prefer to focus on hybrid corporate debt because hybrid corporate debt is subordinated debt of very high quality companies. So you have the advantage of a very sound company, but the spread of a high yield bond due to the subordination. So we think that it is a very smart strategy to buy bonds which are rated double B, but due to the subordination of a very high quality company. Our portfolio is a mix of government debt, investment grade, hybrid, and emerging markets. As of today, we are invested at 60% in government debt, 20% in investment grade, 10%, 15% in euro, and only 5% in emerging markets. So today, we like very much government debt, but inside this universe, we favor inflation-linked government debt because inflation break-evens are very low and very attractive. Because due to the coronavirus crisis, today the market believes that inflation will stay very low in the short term, and probably there is a short-term risk of deflation in some countries. But on a longer term, inflation will peak. So it's very interesting to buy very low inflation break-even today and to wait for higher inflation fears by the market in the next 6 to 9 months. So inflation, very low today, very low in the future in our own view, but market perception is that inflation is low, but inflation will increase in 1 year, 2 years. So it's good to buy inflation-linked bond today when they are cheap, because if you are waiting for inflation fears to buy inflation-linked bonds, it will be too late because the price of the bond will be too high. So if you are not authorized to buy gold to protect you against inflation, TIFFs are really the place to be, the sweet spot against inflation. Yes, ESG is definitely increasing in our in our view, and it's becoming one of the main pillars of our investment process. Nobody will buy your equity. Nobody will buy your bond. And if you are a fund manager and if you are not ESG compatible, nobody will buy your fund. So once, I think in a 3-5 years horizon, everybody will be ESG, and it will be useless to mention that you are ESG because it will be obvious. That's why we decreased our investments in some emerging markets last year. We started to decrease investment in emerging markets in 2019 because we sold some emerging bonds that are not ESG compatible with our new investment process. So when I mentioned that we will increase the weight of high-quality emerging markets, obviously, we will consider ESG factors in our bond selection, and we will avoid some issuers. I think that it is very important to mention that. The coronavirus crisis is on a very short term deflationary, because unemployment rates are increasing dramatically in some countries. So wages will stay low, inflation will stay low, imports from China will decrease for some goods. So in the future, inflation will increase. So it is deflationary in the short term, but in the medium term, inflation fears will start again.